Hi, this is Gene Strickland. I wanted to give you a quick tip for cropping and resizing your images for the web. Remember, your camera is shooting at 10 megapixels or 12 megapixels or 14 megapixels or 16 megapixels or 20 megapixels. You just never know. There's so many different cameras out there, but they're all too big to post your images online with. They're made for printing. So notice this particular fine art portrait that I made. Now, we're zoomed in a bit, right? You can see the percentage right here, 119.6%. So if I hit Command 0, that's for Mac, hit Control 0 for PC users, and it will shrink your image to fit within your viewing window. So looking at the ruler bar at the top, you can see it's 12 inches by 15 inches. That was just because I had resized it smaller a moment ago. Whenever you need to step back in time, just hit Command Z. Or Control Z on a PC, and that's just basically undoing the last step you just did. It's a good way to step backwards, but you can also go to Edit, Undo State Change, or just step forward and backwards. All right, cropping. If you choose the crop tool, which is the fourth one down, it's the fifth one down, right here, and ratio should show up by default. If not, set it to ratio. You have all these other presets you can use, but for now, we're just going to focus on ratio. When you crop, kind of don't let the important parts of your subject get too close to the border of your image. It just feels tight visually. It feels constricted. So always leave a little breathing space. Not too much, but just a little breathing space. Now notice the rule of thirds grid here. If I wanted to utilize that, I could slide this in until that vertical and horizontal intersection is a point of interest for her face. Now I can make it even better by coming up, and that looks really good for the rule of thirds, but it doesn't look good for her hands because I'm cropping off her hands, and that usually doesn't look good. So if I were to come up a little more, well, that would really focus in on her, but I think it makes it a more casual portrait for this particular instance. For something like this, something like that, any of these I like. So I'm gonna hit enter to lock that in, but notice I lost a few megs, like I got rid of some of the image area, but it's still a giant file. Now here's the resizing part. Go up to Image, Image Resize. What you're going to want to do is note the top. It tells you how big your image is currently, what the pixel dimensions are, and if your width and height are not set up in pixels, hit the drop-down arrow and change it like they were on inches. Just change it to pixels. So now that it's changed to pixels, I want you to resize the longest dimension to 800 pixels. So the width here is 2577. That's a bigger number than 2390. So I'm just going to hit 800, and that's going to automatically resample my image. Now notice the resolution. This will change things. If I set this to 72, which we're supposed to, right? Anything that goes on the web is a default 72 pixels per inch resolution. But notice what happened. It shifted my width and height. Well, let me go back up and change this back to 800. I haven't clicked OK yet, so nothing's been officially applied to my image. I can click inside this window and just drag it down, and so I can see the actual size that will show up online. And that's beautiful. That's a really large, perfect image for online viewing. It wouldn't print very well now because it's going to be pretty small. Notice it's only 1.70 meg, and it was 17.6 meg. But I'm not printing this. I'm just using it online. So I verify my longest dimension of the two is 800. My resolution is 72. Always keep this resample checked. And click OK. Hit Command 0 to zoom back in. I can go back up to image size just to verify. Notice my width and my height are 72. Perfect. Now, what you may get, and let me open another image. I'm going to open this image. Now, I shot this in RAW, so that's why it's coming up with the raw camera dialog box, which we'll talk about much, much later. So I'm just going to open that image into Photoshop. Now personally, I think this one's a tiny bit flat and it's got some other issues, but I'm gonna let that go for now. I'm just gonna focus on the cropping. Actually, I like the cropping. It's a little centered, so maybe I wanna uncenter that a little, but I do like the pumpkin stuff going on. I want to leave, even a subtractor, I want to give it some breathing room. So maybe I want to keep all of that. And I click OK. Now, how big is this? This is giant, right? Look at that. It's 33 megs. And it's only 9.5 by 13, so I bet it's sized at pretty high DPI. Let's go up to image size. Look at that. That's really a pretty large file. Look at it. It's 4,000 pixels at the longest dimension. So I'm going to change that to 800. I forgot to change my resolution first, so watch what happens when I change this now to 72, which all your images should have a resolution of 72 for uploading to the web. Well, it reconfigured everything, so I need to go back up here and choose 800. Probably the smarter thing would be to change your resolution first, then to change your longest dimension, which I brought up two wide photographs, so my longest dimension is always the width. Make sure resample is checked, and it tells me it's going to go down from 33.7 megs to 1.32 megs. I'm going to hit OK. Now I'm going to go to File, Save As, and I want you to name these the way it's listed in the project specs. I believe that's written as the project number, so P1 underscore shot number. So this is shot 1, S1. Now you're going to have 10 shots, so obviously you would go S1 through S10. Your last name, Strickland underscore Gene. That's how I would save mine. Now mine defaulted to JPEG. If yours didn't, just under Format, hit the drop-down arrow, and scroll up and down until you get to JPEG. If you notice it won't let you choose a JPEG unless it says it's trying to save it as a copy, that probably means you have multiple layers, and that's okay. Still save a copy. It will automatically flatten it when it makes it a JPEG. Definitely check embed color profile if it says sRGB. Now here, I don't want Adobe RGB because that is for print. If you use Adobe RGB for web, the colors will often look kind of muted and flat, and then it'll look like it's low contrast because the browser is trying to convert that color space to internet color space. And camera color space, internet color space is all sRGB. So I'm going to uncheck. I don't want it to embed that profile. I want it to keep what's native to JPEG. I'm going to click Save. Now here's the part I want to show you. It pops up with all your JPEGs. The quality, 12, that's maximum quality. Notice the megapixels, the 603K. Now notice it's a 1.32 meg image. So JPEG compresses, remember? It throws a little bit of data away to shrink the file size when it saves it. If you were to take this down to 10, this is the low edge of maximum. Notice the new compression, it's 323. You cannot visually tell a difference between the quality of 10 and a quality of 12 in an online image. But it's half the file size. This adds up when you have thousands of images. So typically, unless it's ultra important, I tend to always save as a 10, just to save space over time. Hit OK, and I can hit Command 0 to fill this image up. See, this image still looks great. It looks as good as it did before. I'm only at 72.5%, notice. So I hit Command Plus to zoom in a bit. This is 100%. You can hit Control Plus to zoom in on a PC. And this image looks great. If I hold down the space bar, it'll convert whatever tool I'm on to a hand so I can kind of scroll around the image. Well, I hope this helps with your image resizing and project naming.